and I'm moving on to procedures and functions. 1D array, 2D array, then linear search and bubble sort also will be covered, no problem. But let me move on to, by the way, can you recall the term, the three terms, procedures, functions, and library routine? Can you recall these terms? Any idea? Yes.
I think procedures, they return a value. And library routines are programs that are already pre-tested.
Correct, good.
And reused, so they are available for us to use.
Fine. Let me make it simpler for you. That actually, if I just say library routine is correctly said, you are going to have the routine that are pre-written, pre-tested, and you're just using them. But as far as procedures and functions are concerned, just remember one thing. Procedures do not return a value and functions return a value. So this is the main thing that you need to remember. Functions returning a value and procedures do not return a value. So this is the basic thing. Okay? Fine? Now, moving on to the routine. As you can see, this is something that we have already talked about. Programming languages include library routines that are ready to incorporate into a program. The routines are fully tested and ready for use. A programming language IDE usually includes a standard library of functions and procedures, as well as an interpreter and/or a compiler. These standard routines perform tasks such as input/output that are required by most programs. There can be anything like. We have discussed a few library routines in our classes, if you remember, when we were working in the beginning with left and right and mid and all these functions. So they all are library routines. Ready-made routines, they are here for me. I'm only going to be implementing it, that's all, using it. That's what is the beauty of the library routines. So I hope that there's no question regarding this thing. So we all are clear about the library routines. This is my chapter number 11.3, structured programming. Before I proceed on to this procedure, there are a few terms that I need to know. First one is parameter. Second one is by value, by reference, which I'm leaving temporarily. Header, which is the procedure or function, like the first statement in the definition of a procedure or function that tells what are you doing, like what is the name. Like, for example, if I'm meeting someone, we normally, the very first thing that we ask is the name. So similarly, if I talk about a procedure or a function, so every procedure or function or a library routine must have a name, and that is what is called its header. And then another one is an argument, the value passed to a procedure or a function. So now we'll move on to, you can see parameter, a variable applied to a procedure or function that allows one to pass in a value for the procedure to use. Now there is a minor difference between the two. In some places, they are used interchangeably, but we need to know, be aware of this thing. Procedures. When writing an algorithm, there are often similar tasks that, for example, why do we need it? If, for example, I have some task that is being repeatedly needed at many places. So rather than writing it again and again, what I do is I write it down in a procedure, and I keep on using it whenever I need. Okay, I'll give you an example. If you actually know garam masala. Any idea about the term garam masala? What is it actually?
It's a masala that is used in dishes, I think.
You have any idea about how is it being prepared?
No.
Okay, it's actually a combination of five spices, and up to me whether I put them all together and grind them and put them in a jar and use whenever I need to. But on the contrary, one more option is, like, for example, if I'm a really good cook, then I'll prefer that every time I am cooking, I'll be using these ingredients and will be preparing it just then and there. That is also the same thing. So that is the difference between the two. So what I'm doing is I prepared a complete, because I don't have time. So what I do is I have prepared it once, kept it in the fridge, and whenever I need, I'm using it. That is what is the procedure. Using it whenever you need to. So the same thing is going to happen in our programming. Now, one thing that you need to see is, you can see the same thing. How is it being written? Procedure. The keyword, as you can see here, is procedure, procedure name, statements, and then procedure. the way we have learned for to next, so similarly now we are learning that how do we distinguish a procedure from a function. Its name, the word itself, is going to depict it's a procedure or a function. So it can be defined in this manner in your pseudocode: procedure, procedure name, and then how will it be identified. The way we talked about the name, similarly procedures also have names, and whatever you want that will be written, and then you are going to end by using the term end procedure. Then how will it be called? And this call statement will be used in procedure only. I mean, I will not be using this call in function. I'll be using this call only in procedure. And you can see it can be called many times. Whenever I need to, the way I said, I have prepared that garam masala and all spices and then kept it in the fridge. I can use it whenever I want to. That is what is the idea behind creating a procedure and then calling it wherever you need to. So you may call that procedure many times. As you can see, an example is mentioned below. For example, a procedure to print a line of stars. Like maybe that line of stars is needed many times. So rather than actually writing down that line repeatedly, that program repeatedly, what I can do is I can have a program written, a small program written. As you can see, by the way, procedure. What is the name of the procedure here?
Stars.
That's great. And these brackets are a little bit thing. That what are, does this star? Is the procedure, and it is receiving one value that is called, that is stored in the number. And then what is the data type of that number? It's an integer. So now we are starting the loop. We say for count equals to one to number, output asterisk, next counter, and then end procedure. So what will happen is that once you are running this, once you are making this procedure, it knows what it has to do. It knows that I will be getting a number. And the, I have to perform the activity that is written inside that much number of times. For example, if I want to print 10 stars, then the number will hold 10. And in another line, maybe I want to print 15 stars. So since I am using something here in the form of a variable, so it means that now this procedure is going to print as is sent to it. Whatever the command is sent to it, it will do it accordingly. So if it was sent 10, it will print 10 times. If it was instructed to print 15 times, it will print 15 times. So that will be mentioned here. So you can see, and calling will be a little bit, will vary in this situation because of the reason that you are calling it with a certain different value. So this is what is going to happen, and how will you write it in Visual Basic? You can see here. And how will you call it Visual Basic? That is also mentioned here. So we will keep on referring to these chapters in Challenge A2 as well. So because they are linked with each other. So are you clear with this? Yes.
Yes.
It is often useful. Now let's move on to the two terms that we talked about: parameters and then by value or by reference. Now it is often used to pass a value to a procedure that can be used to modify the actions taken. For example, to decide how many stars would be output, this is done by passing a parameter. Now, this is what is called the parameter. The variable that we call, that we were aware of till now. Now, this is given a special name, and that is given the name parameter. Like this number, although this number is a variable, but this is given a special name. And now, this will be, this should be the data type, should definitely be same from the main program. Like, for example, if I say I am passing on a number value, so then that will be declared as an integer. It can't be a string, or it can't be a real value, it can't be any other value. It has to be exactly the same. Otherwise, there can be a problem. And this is what we, again, we have to be cautious whenever we are working on it. Now, let's move on to the next thing. A procedure with parameters can be defined in pseudocode. Now, you can see this one's example was given earlier, and now they are talking about the discussion. In your pseudocode, procedure, procedure name. Then you can see parameter data type, comma, parameter data type. And that can contain a number of parameter, a number of parameters in the data type will be mentioned here. So you can see this is going to be now the same. It can be called many times, no matter whether you are just working on a simple procedure or whether you are working in procedure with parameters. Still, the word call is going to call the procedure from the program. Remember, procedure is made somewhere else and it is called whenever it is needed. The way I talked about, I had prepared the garam masala once and kept it in a jar, and I'm using it as many times as I need to. It may vary. Maybe 15 times or maybe 20 times I'm using the same jar, and my work is minimized. My work will be minimized. So call is working in the same manner, taking the jar out of the fridge and putting it in my food. That is called the calling. Now, by the way, the same thing is mentioned here. You can see, but by the way, there should. By the way, what is it? What is it happening? It says output 10 times. Now you can see, I think it is 10 times the star is. It will always print 10 times. It won't be actually changing the values for user's choice. But on the contrary, if I say the other program that we have just touched right now, that is going to change because of the instruction given to it. Ki mujhe number ka input jo bhi aa raha hoga, that will be handled kitni martaba usko kaam karna chahiye. That will be this idea. How to call? Call stars 7. This is perfectly possible. Or I can have a variable which is going to store the value, and then I will pass on that variable to the stars procedure. These both are similar in nature. Like their working will be similar in nature, although there is a little difference in how to write, because here I'm using a constant value here, 7. 7 means just a digit. But on the contrary, here I'm storing that 7 in a variable first and then passing on that variable. That's perfectly okay. They both are perfectly okay. And I may suggest you that you can even do it in one more way, that you can ask the person that how many stars do you want to print. So whatever he says, that will be stored in a variable, and that variable can be passed on as well. So there are different ways of handling the same thing. You can do it in any way, whether you want to give us a number, perfectly correct. You want to store that number in a variable and then pass on that, that is also correct. Or you can take input, and then whatever the input is given by the user will be passed on, that is also correct. So I hope that this is a very brief. So are you clear with this, yes or no?
Yes.
Let's concentrate on these terms, by value and by reference. By value means the actual value. For example, if I say 7, 7 will always remain 7. 7 will not change. As you can see, by value, a method of passing a parameter to procedure in which the value of the variable cannot be changed by the procedure. The value of the variable remains same. So you can see that if I say 7, if I say my number is holding 7, so it means that my number will always keep on holding 7, the value will not change. But on the contrary, if I say by reference, a method of passing a parameter to a procedure in which the value of the variable can be changed by the procedure. It means, for example, if I'm referring to a location in the memory, a location to the memory means its reference. So it means references may change, reference values may change. So if I say by reference, it means that if earlier the value was, if I say call star 7, that will be called by calling the procedure by a value, because the value 7 will always remain same. But on the contrary, if I say a variable, I'm using a variable for the purpose. So whatever is the variable location, whatever the value is at that time, that will be taken as a value, and or then will be passed on to the procedure. So you can see the difference is very clear. By value means it will always remain as it is, because there is no such change. But on the contrary, by reference, it will change definitely, because now it is referring to a location in the memory. And location in the memory can hold data at one time and can hold another data at another time. So that is why by reference means it is referring to the memory location, where whatever data will be, that will be passed on to the procedure. But on the contrary, by value means the value as it is, it won't change at all, it will always be the same. So I hope that that is a very, can say, there is a difference that we need to understand and remember. Not a difficult thing, but this is what we need to be very much cautious about. Yes, Beta, any problem in understanding the concept of by value and by reference? You can see when a parameter is passed by value, if variable is used, the value of that variable cannot be changed within the procedure. When a parameter is passed by reference, the value of the variable passed as a parameter can be changed by the procedure. So you can see that that is the difference. By value means the value remains same, but on the contrary, by reference means the value may change, because the value is referring to a location in the memory, and that may change. And similarly, we do mention, by the way, we do mention, if I'm using, then I do mention that thing. This is another example. So you can see the here they are talking about, here we are using it by using byref. Like here I have to mention the term, and only then it will make the procedure work with byref. So you can see this is the syntax, procedure, identifier name, byref, and then we have the again the same thing. Now there's one example, and if you look at the example is of converting from one form to another. Procedure, Celsius, the name of the procedure is Celsius, byref, temperature, colon, real. So it means that you can see here the byref is being used and temperature is a value, is a variable that is being sent to it to the procedure, and the data type is real. Then what are we doing is we are performing the calculation. You can see temperature will be converted. You can see the simple conversion is being done, calculation is being done, and the new value is stored in again the temperature variable. So you can see here, this is going to happen. Call Celsius, my temp, whatever is held in my temp, that will be sent here. And then calculations will be done. And then definitely the work will be done for you. So that is what is the iterative procedure. Okay, this is doing the task here, not returning a value as such. So this is going to be a procedure for that. Converting from Celsius to Fahrenheit and vice versa. You can go for another procedure for converting from. Now, when, apart from procedures, we are going to learn functions as well. When returning, when writing an algorithm, there are often similar calculations or tasks to perform that make use of the same group of statements. Again, the same, and always produce the answer. Instead of repeating these statements every time they are required, what we can do is many programming languages make use of subroutines or name functions. A function always returns a value. It is defined once and can be called many times. Now, this is the same, defined once and can be called many times. And the way we are calling is different. As you can see, functions can be used on the right-hand side of an expression. Now, this is very important. Functions are always going to return a value which is written the way I say A equals to left of Pakistan, 3. So A will be actually on the left-hand side that will hold the value that is being returned. Function name returns. By the way, this is what is the difference between this. We can see the word returns is there. So the moment you see the word returns, although the word function is missing, maybe there is a question in your paper that has a few empty lines, a few blanks. So whenever the word returns is being used, is ka matlab, it is a function. We can't use returns with the procedure. And then returns in the data type. We just mentioned that what is the data type of the returned value. Statements, whatever you want. And then we have end function. The way there it was end procedure, here it is end function. So you can see here. Now again, the thing is the same. The word procedure is replaced by function here. The identifier, the name of the function. Then we have the parameters. That is also possible. If maybe this function is not receiving any value, but it's doing something inside, that's all. And on the contrary, if I say this one, this is getting some values as well, which are the parameters. And again, the word returns. So this returns is a compulsory thing. So the moment you see this word returns, that means it is a function. There you get the same thing. The keyword returns is used as one of the statements in a function to specify the value to be returned. This is usually the last statement, the function definition. There can be more than one return used in the function if there are different paths through its statements. This technique needs to be used with great care. For example, a function to find a substring of a given length starting at a given place in a string that returns a null string rather than an error could be. Now, this one is given to you as an example. I think I have seen such a question somewhere in any one of the past papers.